Thank you. The dollar buys a nickel's worth. Banks are going bust. Shopkeepers keep a gun under the counter. Punks are running wild in the street. There's nobody anywhere who seems to know what to do, and there's no end to it. We know the air is unfit to breathe, and our food is unfit to eat. We sit watching our TVs while some local newscaster tells us that today we had 15 homicides and 63 violent crimes, as if that's the way it's supposed to be. We know things are bad, worse than bad. They're crazy. It's like everything everywhere is going crazy, so we don't go out anymore. We sit in the house, and slowly the world we're living in is getting smaller, and all we say is, please, at least leave us alone in our living rooms. Let me have my toaster and my TV and my steel-belted radios, and I won't say anything. Just leave us alone. Well, I'm not going to leave you alone.
There without the wherewithal to bear it all. The heaviness of things that probably isn't there at all. Outside of my own mind, but I like to imagine the moon is still there even when I look away. I would tattoo the spirit of the river on both of my arms if only it could remember its name. It's been 2 weeks since I heard your voice, and I have to ask myself, am I healthy? Then I have to ask myself if that even matters when they're out here killing black people still. This is for my mother, and every time I wish every person was like her. This is for my little sister, and every kindness that hell couldn't squeeze from her eyes like tears that leaked without permission, because she held them back with gritted teeth and middle fingers that she only learned to raise when I made her do it for funny pictures at way too young an age. This isn't the death of pain. This is a prayer for the death of pain that doesn't serve a purpose. This is the firmest reminder I can offer that you are not worthless. I know it's hard to know I care when I could have got a superlative for least likely to listen to anything you have to say, but I won't drink from this cup if it means taking your freedom away. It's okay, but it's not ideal. And that's okay, 'cause I don't think it ever will be. Sometimes you have to do the thing before the time is right. Learning another language, my head too bad to care about being famous. Can I make things better than they are now? The only question in my dome, except when I wonder why everybody won't just leave me alone. I never need a silence so bad till I learn to enjoy it the way you do. The first thing from awkward, my father is never really liked any of my songs, but he likes me. I'm some ass blind in this matter, free chicken nuggets in my pipe dream. And you're there too, and you like me kiss your neck because you like me. Used to get real confused about adverbs, but now I think my favorite one is brightly. I swear all my life I can think of an excuse for not doing any new thing, cause I'm terrified of every single thing I haven't done yet till I do it. But fear is a good way to ruin sanctuaries. What's mainly scary is being maimed and carried by shame and never living up to my name or getting married. So I breathe deep on a couch and try to hold myself together and pretend I feel great because my favorite tether till I implode on a dusty cushion. Trust me, pushing through is worth it, cause how many times has the moment of clarity found me 3 years later in a shower when I feel better? Was willing to follow an omens, but two were too far apart and I got distracted wondering if you lost my teal sweater or if you had to get rid of it knowingly cause some other dude that doesn't quite get what we've been through. Cause we're family, if I love you once, I love you always. My boy Brando constantly be adjusting his balls all day, cause it's hard to get settled on people that made you who you are end up out of reach. Outwardly I shout and talk shit, but on the inside I'm quiet and I'm thankful right now. I'm quiet and I'm thankful forever. I'm quiet and I'm thankful for as long as any part of my body or essence lasts. People that write country songs act like the floor of heaven's glass, but I think that ignores how personally responsible we are for keeping our dead friends by our side. This is for my mom, and every time I wish every person was like her. This is for my best friends, and every time they need a light to help them keep believing in the path they're on. I miss you.